This is a Blender Python tutorial where we'll be going over how to arrange icospheres in a phyllotaxis pattern. Hey, I'm Victor Stepanoff. I'll be guiding you through this beginner Blender Python tutorial. Today, we're going to be taking a look at the sunflower pattern or the phyllotaxis pattern. We'll be referencing a chapter in a book called Algorithmic Beauty of Plants. Here it is. I even was lucky enough to get a physical copy of this book. We'll be taking a look how you can get this particular arrangement of points. We'll take a look at the math behind it. It won't be too complicated, don't worry. I'll try to explain in different ways so you can understand what's going on. With this algorithm, I was able to place icospheres in a particular pattern and then animate them, like for example, what you see on your screen. We won't be going into the animation part today. We'll be just taking a look at placing the icospheres in a particular pattern. So make sure to subscribe to see that video where I explain the animation part itself. I originally stumbled upon Dan Schiffman's tutorial on phyllotaxis on YouTube, and I was able to make a Python version of this code. Make sure to check out his video and give that video a like. I'll leave a link in the description. Now let's take a look at the formula that we'll be using to implement this particular pattern. And if we go down here, here is the two things that we will need to calculate, the angle and the radius. This particular constant right here is going to be the golden angle. It's going to give us this nice pattern as you see right here. So the basic idea of this formula right here is that we're just going to be going around in a circle and just modifying the radius of this particular like vector. You'll see what I mean in just a second. I mapped this formula into a spreadsheet to show you how the numbers will change over the iterations of the point index or n. Right, here's the formula for the angle and here's the formula for the radius, and I'm just plugging in the point index and the divergence angle and getting the current angle. And I'm just continuing to calculate this for every single point index. The same thing goes with the radius that we're calculating over here. One thing I don't like about this in particular is that we're looking at the angle and it's going over 360 and it's starting to be less readable because it's like the angle of like 1512, like what angle is that between 0 and 360? Not really straightforward. So I've added a version of this spreadsheet that actually goes between 0 and 360. So here's the version of the spreadsheet with a modulo operator applied to the angles. As you can see, we don't go higher than 360 and we just loop back around to zero, right? And then just continue from there. I actually have a video on this particular modulo operator and you should check that out if you're not sure what I'm talking about here. All right, and now that we have these, this angle and the radius, what are we going to do with this, right? We can't really use this in Blender. Well, we'll have to convert this from polar to Cartesian coordinates. We'll use a special formula to convert that as well. So here I'm looking at mathisfun.com, and here is a great description of converting from polar to Cartesian coordinates. And as you can see on this example, the radius in our case would be 13 and the angle would be 22.6. And we want to get the X and Y in particular. And to do that, we're going to be using cosine to get the X and then sine to get the Y. I also will add a link to this interactive conversion that you can actually use these sliders right here and change the radius and then change the angle. The formula that we're going to be using literally just does this. It just changes the angle and then changes the radius and gets a new coordinate in the 2D space of X and Y. And that's it. And that's what we're going to do, and just place an icosphere at the end of this particular point. All right, now that we've looked at this, let's jump into Blender and start implementing this formula. In Blender, let's go into the scripting workspace right here at the top. Hit new, And then delete everything from the scene, hit AX and then delete. I'm gonna quickly paste in some comments for us to save time. So you can see what we're going to be doing. At the very top, I'm just adding a comment for this whole script where I'm adding where exactly I'm referencing this formula. Next, at the very top, as usual, we add some special imports, meaning the things that extend Python's functionality, the same thing as Blender gets extended with add-ons. We're extending Python with modules. In particular, we're extending Python with BPY. We're getting some random functionality, meaning we can generate random numbers. And then we'll need to be calculating some conversion between radians and degrees, and that's why we need the math module. At the top of our script, we're going to be defining the C constant and the angle for this formula. The C is going to be the scale factor. I'll set it to 1 for now. If you want, you can change that and update that. For the angle, I'll be using the golden angle. Next, we're going to be repeating this part of the code multiple times where we're calculating the current angle, calculating the radius, and then converting the radius and the angle into a Cartesian space, so X and Y, and then using this X and Y that we calculated and placing an icosphere at that particular location. So instead of C, I'm going to be using a scale fact just to make it a bit more readable. For the angle, I'll set it to the golden angle, so 137.5. Next, I'll define a variable to hold the count, the number of icospheres we want to add into our scene. And now let's add a for loop to repeat this code. I'm going to select all these comments by holding shift and the down arrow and then press tab to indent so Python understands that all this code is going to be repeated in this for loop. The current angle is going to be n times the angle that we defined here. And the radius is going to be the scale fact times the square root of the current index of the point that we're adding. So here I'm using math square root functionality, right? So this is the way that we write square roots in Python. Also, I forgot to convert this from degrees into radians. This is very important because we need radians here and not degrees. Okay, now we need to convert the current angle and the current radius into an X and Y value. At this point, let's check out that I wrote everything correctly, and I'm just going to print out the X and Y coordinates. I'm going to run the script. Okay, there are no obvious errors. I'm going to open up the system console. I'm on Windows. The toggle for the system console is here. On Mac and Linux, you'll need to, unfortunately, do some extra steps to get this going. So I also made a video on that, so check that out if you want this same output. This is what I'm seeing on my end, right? These are the X and Y coordinates, so it looks like it is working. Now it seems that we just need to add the icospheres. Let's do that by hovering over the 3D viewport and hitting Shift A, selecting mesh, and then the icosphere. And let's I'm just going to copy the code. Looks like everything I need is here. It's the radius and the location. I'm going to remove this print right here. Add the icosphere down here. We don't really need the scale, so I'm removing that. I'm going to update the location right here. So I'm going to use X and Y, right? So I'm removing this as well. So the X and Y is exactly the variables that we're saving right here, creating, right, and applying them to this location. All right, now let's delete everything and run the script. Okay, look at that. Looks like we have some pattern going on here. Can't really see it. Let's reduce the size of the icosphere so we can see the pattern better and they're not overlapping. I'm hitting Control Space, by the way, to go in and out of full screen for the viewport. I'm going to go up here outside of the for loop, so we don't need to set this every single time we iterate through the script. It's very important to understand that what you actually need to repeat, like for example, this code right here, we don't really need to repeat multiple times. You just set it once before we start running and iterating over the for loop. So I'm going to set this to ICO here radius, and I'm going to set it to 0.5. I'm going to use this right here instead of this one. All right, I'm going to delete everything by hitting AX and then delete. And then let's rerun the script. All right, look at that. Let's do one more thing. Let's add more of these icospheres. It's going to take a bit more time depending on your hardware. So let's run that again. All right, look at that pattern right there. This is how it looks, and it's similar to what we saw in the book itself. I want to add one final touch to this and create a random number here. As you saw in the book, this angle could be different. You can d get different patterns. Probably the coolest one is 137.5, but we can use this and see what other patterns we can get. I'm going to use random. So I'm going to be using the random uniform function, and I'm going to be going between 137.0 and let's go 138. You can experiment with other angles, but I think they won't really produce anything interesting. But I think you should definitely try this out on your own and see what happens if you apply other angles outside of this particular range. So I'm going to delete all of this. I'm going to set this to let's go with 300 just to see the results a bit faster. I'm going to run the script. Okay, we have this spiral going on here. Let's see, move it like so. Let's do another iteration. Oh, I should have probably cleaned the scene, but yeah, now it's kind of weird. Actually, you know what? That could be also cool. Like you could do something with that. Let's run that again. It looks like a bit similar to the last one. Anyway, you get the idea now that we have this random uniform and selecting a random angle each time we iterate through the script. All right, and that is everything that I wanted to share with you today. I hope that you learned something new and enjoyed this video. So make sure to give this video a like. For more videos like this, make sure to subscribe. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.